With me this afternoon here in the studio from Alien Metals, I'm joined by Bill Brodie Good. Bill, good afternoon. Nice to
good
see
afternoon.
You.
Nice to see you again.
Look, a busy and active start to the new year for you. Plenty to catch up on. You've recently returned from a site visit to Mexico.
Yeah, I had the pleasure to go to Mexico for just over a week. Important to see the projects for myself. As a geologist, it's very important to get on the ground, kick some rocks. Really informative, met the team, the Mexican team, had a good session with the technical guys there, and girls, sorry. Had some good visits to our project areas, and also we had the we were invited by Endeavour Silver to actually go underground on their El Compass project, which is it's a very similar project to our Los Campos project. They're obviously more advanced because they're currently mining, but it's a narrow vein, high grade, epithermal silver, silver and gold. But it was really interesting to see the operation, see the mentality, learn the mentality in that region of Mexico, specifically of how narrow vein, high grade projects can be very economic and doable. It was excellent, really good visit.
So you've got Los Campos and two others there, have you?
So we've got Los Campos, which is a silver, again, a historic silver mine, only a few kilometers from the El Compass project of Endeavour, right on the edge of the Zacatecas city. And then we have the San Celso silver project further out, much more a standalone in terms of location. However, I feel that's got even more potential. Really excellent location, amazing amount of sort of surface float material of grade material, but the old timers just weren't interested in because they couldn't process. We're looking at doing some more work very soon and actually getting back underground to have a bit of a better understanding of what's going on. And the Donovan 2, which is the copper gold volcanic massive sulfide VMS target, again close to San Celso, in not far from Zacatecas. Got on the ground there, got some really excellent float samples that we cracked them open, and there's visible copper, there's visible sulfides, and also talking to some of the local party potential joint venture partners,
right,
discussing a little bit how we'd move forward, what they're looking for, how things would work. So excellent all-round trip. And very interesting from my point of view as a geologist, and for understanding and how we develop the projects going forward.
And as far as some upcoming drilling, how's the permitting and the like?
The permitting's in process. We're just finalising now. The final thing is we need a drilling company to provide sort of environmental spec on the drilling machine. Managed to have a site visit to the drillers, discuss the specific machine, very small compact unit, track mounted. They're just providing us with those details that then are the final document that goes into the request. So I'm hoping, again, with processing and everything, probably another few weeks to get the permission. And then hopefully we've got a plan for San Celso, Los Campos, and Donovan 2, although Donovan 2 will be more surface IP, ground IP, induced polarisation to identify a better target. Looking hopefully for Q2, obviously funds, having the available funds to start putting the test drill holes in, which is very exciting times.
Indeed. You're off to Australia next
week.
I'm
off to Australia on Monday.
What's on the agenda?
The agenda is some meetings again in, I'll basically be in Perth, so a meeting with possible interested parties on both our Australian projects and potentially the broader silver aspects of what we have at the moment. I'm going up to the Hammersley, the Pilbara, for specifically we're going to the Hancock project to look at the BHP-20 target prospect. We've done some work on that in the last few weeks. We've got what we feel is a very competent schematic interpretation of how this structure sits, how potentially the ore deposit that hopefully is there trends into the tenement. So we're going to go up on site, kick some rocks, take a few samples if we get the time, dependent on the cyclone, because it is cyclone season. So that might stop us, but other than that. And going up to Elizabeth Hills, the silver project. Again, kick a few rocks. We've been doing some research, database compilation on that one as well. There's a few anomalies I'm going to try and resolve while on site, picking up some old drill collars. There seems to be some discrepancies on actual physical locations. And again, looking at some rocks, looking at the infrastructure, getting more of a, in my head, an idea of what's needed for moving forward.
And looking to update that resource.
That's the plan at the moment. That the main focus has been quite a lot of work done, obviously, a lot of drilling. The mining commenced, the mining wasn't completed by the previous holders. So we know there's still a sizable resource still in the ground, in the underground section. However, we also have seen that there's potentially a surface open pitable resource as well. The data work will see what gaps there are potentially in the information we need. There may be a case of we might need to drill 6 or 8 holes to infill the data, all the data we have, to then hopefully update a resource. And then that'll help us move forward, obviously. And also, of course, look at the satellite targets that exist on this project. Some work's been done on them, some they're still untested. So again, to try and prioritize and bring those up to speed as quickly as possible.
And you've got some partners on some of these, have you?
Not at the moment, no. We're right. Still, we're in discussion with several people, several parties, as I said earlier. And we do have some quite solid interest, but obviously it takes time to, from our point of view, we want to really know exactly what we've got, because obviously, so we have a true value of the projects we have. We don't necessarily want to give them away. And I think from our part, some of the people we're talking to, specifically from the Mexican trip, there were specific points of request. Maybe you need a couple of drill holes, maybe you need XYZ. That will give them potentially the confidence to feel that actually there is, that we know is there and they know is there, but actually for to have some drill intersections, significant drill intersections, things like that.
And what about reviewing some other projects? Are you finding many are being presented to you at the moment?
Well, while I was in Mexico, we were presented with 2 projects, one in the same region as Zacatecas region, which is sort of south central Mexico, a second one further north, still in a good solid part of Mexico in terms of security, access, mining history. So we're looking at that. We've had a couple of projects cross our desk for Australia as well, quite sizable, potentially sizable, mainly gold projects, and also a couple of smaller but still quite interesting projects in Africa that we're, you know, gradually going through. Obviously we need to process these fairly quickly, otherwise, as parties obviously talk to several people, but we're trying to make sure that we don't go too far too quickly, so that we don't want to start picking up, grabbing things here and there without really doing a proper due diligence, because I feel at the moment we have quite a sizable amount to get on with, which is, we're in a great position in that respect.
Well, we might catch up on your return from Australia.
Well, I hope so, yeah. I'll give you some, yeah, I'll try and get some photos and even the odd video and send it through.
Very good. Bill, thank you.
Thanks for your time.